Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to another tutorial, and today we are going to talk about texturing. So as you can see in my screen, today we are going to texture the leather and the fabric. But one important thing about the fabric is that I have used only one bitmap to make this incredible texture. So I'm going to show you how I made it using one bitmap, and also I'm going to show you how to texture this beautiful leather on my screen. Okay, so it's a very simple workflow. It will take a few minutes to texture it. So let's take a look. Let's get started. Okay guys, so first of all, I wanna show you the two main websites where I get my textures. So textures.com and Polygon, probably you have already heard about them. Also, there is a plugin I'm using in this tutorial, and the name of it is Wrangler. I'm gonna show you how it works. So that we are going to texture like a leather, and you're going to texture a fabric. So this is the leather, and this is the fabric I got from textures.com and Polygon. Okay, so let's start with the leather. Okay, so I'm gonna select this ottoman, and I'm gonna show you how this plugin works. Actually, you have to create a material, so have to select this material and then press Ctrl Shift T. Then here we have the folder where my assets are placed. So I'm gonna select the albedo, also the glossiness, the normal map, and the reflection. Okay, so apply it, and as you can see here, it applied automatically. So let's take a look. Okay, it's not bad, but the leather is too light, too bright, and maybe too big. So let's decrease the tile of this bitmap. So go to the scale and scale it down to something, I don't know, maybe 0.5. Yeah, maybe it's still big, 0.35. Okay, I think it's a good number. So let's play with the gamma of the albedo. So let's increase a little bit to gain some contrast, something like this. And let's apply a color correct to this node. So Shift A, S to search, and then type color correct. So yeah, this one, plug it to the texture, and let's bring the exposure down. So I don't know, maybe 0.8 less, maybe 0.9. Yeah, it's not bad. Definitely is not bad. Maybe let's put something 0.99. Yeah. So let's play with the roughness to gain some reflections here. So let's decrease the gamma to 0 just to see what happens. So as you can see here, now we are having much more reflections on our ladder. So let's increase it to maybe 0.8, 0.6, I think. 0.6 probably is a good number. We gain some reflection on the front. Yeah, I think it's good. It's not bad at all. Okay, one thing very nice about this Wrangler add-on is that it actually plug this invert texture to the roughness and invert like the glossiness. So it's a good thing. It, like, I know that it's just click on invert, but it helps, you don't need to worry about that. So let's decrease the saturation a little bit of this ladder, and maybe decrease a little bit more the exposure. Okay, so I think we got a really good result. As you can see, we have a really nice reflections, really nice normal going on the ladder. So definitely Octane does a really good job on the normal maps and the displacement, because now we are going to talk about the displacement map. As I said, I used only one bitmap to create that beautiful fabric. So this is something that I really, really like about Octane. Like, it really does a really good job. Okay, so let's take a look on the texture for this fabric. So let's import it and see what happens. Okay, so just a second, let me find it on my folder. Where is it? Hold on just a second. Here. Okay, so as you can see here, we have a high resolution texture. That's important. Okay, so the first thing we have to do is create a node called displacement. So Shift A, S for search, then type displacement. Then plug it to the texture node, to the texture slot, and then plug it to, oops, sorry about that, and plug it to the displacement material. Okay, so let's change it to 4K, adjust the mid level, so 0.5. As the standard, the height, let's increase it to something like 7 and maybe a little bit more, just to see what happened. And we have to apply a full transform to this bitmap, so right click on the bitmap, go to Octane, and then add a transform, then apply it, pressing OK. So let's scale the bitmap down a little bit, 0.2. Yeah, I think this is the number. I don't know if this is the number I used in this one, but I think it is. I think it is. So 0.2 is the number, and as you can see, we have a beautiful, beautiful displacement happening here. So as I said, Octane does a really good job on displacement, so I really like it. It's amazing. It's really amazing. Okay, so as you can see, I didn't do anything in this bitmap, and this is actually how I do most of my fabrics. Actually, using Octane, like after switch to Octane, like I change a little bit my workflow because I don't need to adjust the textures. Of course, sometimes I need, but if you have a really good texture, a really good high resolution texture, definitely you won't need to like make any adjustments. Okay, so this is something that speed up the process as well. Okay, so I think we have to apply the same texture to this part of the blanket. So to do that, I'm gonna copy this material and paste it to this part of the object. Okay, so just plug it on the slot and let's just decrease the height a little bit because I think it's too much. Yep, that's very nice. Beautiful. Maybe increase a little bit to something like 8. Yeah, very nice. Okay, we are gonna do a thing that I didn't do on the main image. So let's try to put a fall off on this fabric. This is something that sometimes I use, and it definitely increased the realism of the fabric. So Shift A, S to search, and then type fall off. This fall off texture. So to make it work, we have to add a mix texture as well. So type mix texture on the search and just plug the falloff on the amount. Yep. And let's search for RGB spectrum as well. So type RGB spectrum texture and place it to the texture one. And let's copy it, place it to, actually change it to black and place it to the texture two. Place mix material to the albedo color. And let's take a look how it works. Actually, you have to probably change the position of the white and the black. Let's play with this big ball over here. Actually, this big ball helps us to understand where like the light color will be shown. So it's important. Let's just unplug the displacement just to see how it works. So let's play with the grazing here. Actually, I don't have like a recipe for that because we have to play with the numbers and see how it looks and what's the best results. So things like that, it's the best way, okay? So one thing is important, the normal vector 90 degrees. This is important for fabrics, okay? So this is something that you must to set. Okay, so let's plug the texture displacement again, see what happened. Maybe something is wrong here. Actually, after plug the displacement, we can see that the light color is under the black color. So we have to change it. Let's just try to play with the numbers on the fall off, but probably we have to invert the colors. Okay, so let's play with the grazing again to see what we can get. Maybe the normal here. Now let's change the orientation of this ball. Yeah, something like this. Yeah, the fall off skew actually as well. Yeah, let's just reduce. Let's get back to what we had. Probably this fall off here have to decrease it a lot and invert the black and white texture. Okay, let's invert it and see the result. Oh yeah, that's it. So now we have like, definitely we have a different result than the main image. But this result definitely, I think it's much more realistic. Definitely it is. Let's just wait for like the render a little bit more, see the result, but I'm seeing it. It's definitely something like I'm gonna pay attention on my fabrics from now on. This is something very, very nice. As you can see here, we don't have this fall off happening. So this fall off is definitely like giving this really nice cozy blanket like on this ottoman. So really nice. So as you can see in my original image, we have this hair on the blanket. So let's create it. Actually, it's very easy to do that. Okay, so I'm gonna show you how to do that in simple steps. Okay, so the first step is you have to go to the particle properties. Have to select your blanket, go to the particle properties, add a particle, go to hair, decrease the hair length to something, I don't know, 0.5, very small, okay, something like this. Increase the number of particles. So here we have like 1,000 particles. Let, I don't know, increase to 80,000 particles. So Actually, you have to activate the advanced here, the advanced option, and then go to this Brownian, go to actually physics and Brownian, and let's put something like 0.005. And yeah, as you can see here, we have this very crazy mass hair. So let's take a look how it is. Okay, actually it's not working because we have to give thickness to the hair. So go to the Octane hair set settings and let's increase the root thickness to something, I don't know, maybe 100, no, 10, maybe more. Actually, I'm seeing it, but it's not very visible yet. So increase it to 50, and now we have something interesting. So the tip thickness, let's increase it to maybe 3. And yeah, here we go. I think it's time for a big render. So press F12 to start the rendering. Let's wait a little bit. Actually, I have to wait a little bit to see it. But I'm very impressive about actually this fall off. It looks really nice. So I'm very happy with the result. I hope you are as well. Very nice. So as you can see here, we have a really nice like hair on this blanket, and it definitely gives a really good realism on the image. So this is something you have always to think about when you want to achieve realism. Okay guys, so I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like, please subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to leave your message as well, okay? And see you in the next video.